What if we told you that just using a simple website can help save our world? Seems ridiculous, right? But we are here to prove it's not.
如果我们告诉你仅仅使用一个简单的网站就能拯救我们的世界，听起来很可笑，对吧？但是我们来这里就是为了证明它并不是。大家好，我是 Arthur。
Hello everyone, I'm Bonnie.
And hi, I'm Romain.
Our talk today is about the global crisis, climate change.
我们今天的演讲是关于一个全球危机，全球变暖。
In fifth grade, we watched the documentary A Life on Our Planet by David Attenborough as a summative. This documentary gave us a clear idea of what our world looks like and something inside of us woke.
五年级时，我们观看了大卫·阿登堡的纪录片《我们星球上生活》作为考试。这部纪录片让我们清楚地了解到我们的世界是什么样子，并且什么是气候变化。
According to the documentary, in 2030, the Amazon rainforest degrades into a dry savanna, causing extinction. In the Arctic, it becomes ice-free in the summer, which causes the speed of global warming to increase because less sunlight is reflected.
根据纪录片所示，科学家预测到2030年，亚马逊雨林将退化为干燥的热带草原，导致灭绝。在北极，它在夏天变得不结冰。这导致全球变暖的速度加快，因为反射的阳光较少。
In 2040, frozen soils thaw, releasing methane, a type of greenhouse gas worse than carbon dioxide.
2040年，冻土融化，释放出初甲烷，一种比二氧化碳更严重的温室气体。
In 2050, as the ocean temperature increases, coral reefs start to bleach and die, and fish populations crash.
2050年，随着海洋的温度升高，珊瑚礁开始变白和死亡，海洋的鱼类数量不明。
In 2080, the soils are exhausted by overuse, causing a crisis in the global food production. Pollinating insects like bees and butterflies disappear, and the weather becomes unpredictable.
在2080年，过度使用土壤造成全球粮食生产危机，蝴蝶。和蜜蜂等传粉昆虫消失，天气变得不可预测。In 2100, as the temperature increases by 4 degrees Celsius, many places are inhabitable and millions of people become homeless. A sixth mass extinction comes. This is something we cannot reverse.
2100年气温上升了40度，许多地方不可居住。数百万人无家可归，第六次大灭绝来临，这是我们无法逆转的。
In fact, climate change is already happening. In Pakistan, people suffered a monster monsoon. And where we are, in China, where we are, a bridge already broke into two because of massive heat waves. In the UK, roads are melting, and in Europe and Africa, people are experiencing the worst drought in hundreds of years. All of this is happening now, and no one is safe.
如今气候变化已经在发生，在巴基斯坦，人们正在遭受一场可怕的季风；在我们所在的中国，一座桥已经因为巨大的热浪而一分为二；在英国，道路正在融化；在欧洲和非洲，人们正在经历数百年来最严重的干旱。所有这些事情都在发生，没有人是安全的。
In places like the North Pole, even ice is melting, like the ice over there.Animals like polar bears have no place to live. And if ice melts, the sea level will rise. And if that problem is ignored, the whole world would be a big flood, not just Pakistan.
甚至在北极等地，气候变化也在发生。冰正在融化，就像这里。像北极熊这样子动物没有地方住。如果我们忽视这个问题，冰将会融化。海平面上升，世界将会遭受一场大洪灾。However, we can still solve this problem.
然而，我们仍然可以解决这个问题。
What we can start doing is using websites such as Ecosia. These websites help us stay climate active while continuing our normal routines.
我们可以开始使用 Ecosia 等网站。这种类型的网站可以帮助我们在保持正常生活的同时保持气候活跃。
For example, Ecosia is a search engine powered by Google.
就像我们刚才所讲到的网站，它是一个被谷歌支持的搜索引擎。
How it works is whenever you search on Ecosia, search ads generate the income for Ecosia, which is the tree they used, which is the money they used to plant trees.
它的工作原理是通过使用网站搜索广告为 Ecosia 带来收入，这是他们用来种树的钱。
Another way to help solve this problem is to raise awareness.
帮助应对气候变化的另一个方法是提高认识。
Raising awareness can help more people understand this problem and do something to make our future bright again.
提高认识可以帮助更多的人了解危机，并且采取措施让我们的未来再次光明。
In fact, doing things like beach cleanups, Earth Hour, and Meatless Mondays can also really help.
做一些事情，比如组织海滩清洁、无肉星期一以及地球一小时，都会很有帮助。
Let's take Meatless Mondays as an example. Every day, an average American consumes 89 grams to 136 grams of meat per day. If we were to do Meatless Mondays with a lot of people, imagine how much less meat we would consume.
让我们以无肉星期一为例，每天美国人平均摄入89克到136克的肉量。如果我们每个人一起去做无肉星期一，想象一下我们会吃我们会少吃多少肉。
Another way to help solve this problem is to stop deforestation and plant trees on deforested land because there is plenty of it. If we could achieve this worldwide, 2/3 of our carbon emissions would be removed.
解决这一问题的另一个方法是停止砍伐森林，并且在被砍伐的土地上植树，因为那里有大量的森林。如果我们能够在全球范围内实现这一目标，我们三分之二的碳排放将被消除。
Speaking of carbon emissions, we can start using renewable energies like solar panels. These renewable energies never run out and are more eco-friendly than burning fossil fuels.
说到碳排放，我们可以开始使用太阳能、风能或太阳能电池板等水能来以此减少碳排放。这些可再生能源永远不会耗尽，而且更加环保。
We need to learn to not come apart from nature, but to be a part of nature. If we protect nature, it will protect us too.
我们需要学会融入大自然，并且成为它的一部分。如果我们保护大自然，它也会保护我们。According to the climate clock, we have 7 years.
根据气候时钟，我们有7年时间。
That isn't a lot of time, but that is enough to solve climate change.
时间并没有那么多，但这足以让我们解决气候变化的问题。
So please, try to remember to do something in the next 7 years, big or small.
所以无论如何，在未来7年里，请对气候变化这件事做出贡献，无论它是大的还是小的。Thank you.
谢谢大家。